Hey everyone, CyberKai here, and this is Current Events episode number 4. Unfortunately, what I'm going to talk about here is reminiscent of my first Current Events video. Amanda Todd is a Canadian girl that posted a video on her YouTube account on September 7th, telling her story of being bullied, which is right here in this link. When she was 12, she would chat with her friends on an internet webcam, just for fun and just to talk. She eventually started getting the attention from people she didn't know, and they were very flattering. However, with how sexually charged kids that age are, they wanted her to flash them. A year later, when she was 13, she did. Shortly afterwards, she got a message on Facebook from a guy she didn't even know, demanding that she put on a strip show for him, or he would send topless photos of her to everyone she knows. He then showed her that he knew her address, he knew her school, and the names of her friends and family. Well, needless to say, she didn't do the strip show. As a result, the police pounded on her door at 4 a.m. during Christmas break, saying that topless photos of her were sent to everyone she knew. After that, she got really sick, she got anxiety, major depression, and a panic disorder. She moved to try and get away from it, but then got into drugs and alcohol. Her anxiety eventually got so bad she couldn't go out in public. A year later, the stalker guy came back out from under his rock. He had her new school and a list of her new friends. He even made a new Facebook page, and his profile picture was her topless. She started crying again and lost all of her new friends and the respect they had for her. The name-calling and the judging started again, and she started cutting. After that, she moved schools and tried to move on without friends. A month later, she started talking to a guy from an old school. He said he liked her, and he eventually let her on, even though he had a girlfriend. After being alone for over a year and desperate for a friend, she bought it hook, line, and sinker. They hooked up when his girlfriend was supposedly on vacation. A week later, he showed up at her school, with his girlfriend and 15 other chicks. The girlfriend then threw a man to the ground and began punching her over and over as other kids filmed the beating. Teachers ran over to help, but she felt so much like crap, she just laid in a ditch until her father found her. When her father got her home, Amanda tried to kill herself by chugging bleach. An ambulance was called and rushed her to the hospital to flush the chemicals out of her system. When she got on Facebook after getting home, all she saw were messages saying that people wished that she was dead. She didn't want to press charges on anyone because she just wanted to move on, even though she was on antidepressants and counseling. After all of that, she moved again. Another city, another school. For months afterwards, she kept being tagged in photos of bleach and ditches. People were saying how she should try a different brand of bleach, and how she should actually die next time. In her video she posted in September, she wondered why everyone followed her or why she was still alive. On October 10, 2012, Amanda took her own life. Coroner Barb McClintock said the case will be long and complex. She also said they know how she died, but they are not going to release that information. At least not anytime soon. McClintock also said that after the review is complete, there may be recommendations made on a range of issues, including cyberbullying, though she noted that it would take time given how complicated it can be to deal with the internet. Sergeant Peter Thyssen, spokesman for the Royal Canadian Mounted Police, said they are conducting interviews and reviewing any potential contributing factors to her death. He also said investigators are monitoring social media and that victim services are speaking with the teen's family. He also said, and I quote, "This is a devastating tragedy which impacts the community as a whole. Our deepest sympathies go out to the family and friends of this young person," end quote. Then he added that bullying ranks second behind substance abuse for youth issues identified as concerns for the RCMP. This story made international headlines and was covered by CNN, Washington Post, and the UK's Daily Mail, just to name a few. Countless messages of empathy and outrage were trending on Twitter and several Amanda Todd memorial sites that were set up on Facebook. But not all the chatter was positive, mainly because this world is full of teenagers, which can be referred to as narrow-minded pieces of decomposing baby fat. Unfortunately, this topic only gets attention when a victim of bullying dies, whether or not it's by their own hand. This time, however, it caught the attention of the Premier of British Columbia, Christy Clark. She said, quoting, "No one deserves to be bullied. No one earns it. No one asks for it. It is not a rite of passage. Bullying has to stop. Every child has to feel safe at school." End quote. To all of you heartless sacks of personified horse crap, are you freaking happy now? I can't believe all of you dandruff-looking douchebags would seriously do that to someone. I bet some of the people that ridiculed her make donkey shit look sexy. Jamie Rottemeyer? Billy Lucas? Mitchell Wilson? Amanda Cummings? Seth Walsh? Phoebe Prince? Amanda Todd? How many more kids need to take their own lives before this issue is taken seriously by lawmakers? Or do there need to be more cases like Matthew Shepard? In my opinion, not all the blame lies with the bullies themselves. These worthless runts weren't taught how to be considerate or empathetic by their parents, and instead probably spoiled them rotten. Without being taught how to be good people, they're now nothing more than cruel, inconsiderate, hypocritical mental midgets that cry like worthless little brats when someone says anything bad to them. The parents of these bullies should be charged with crimes against humanity. Conceiving these ignorant needle dicks and letting them live should be considered a heinous crime. All these bullies do is hinder the prosperity of society. That's why these memes exist. So, if you saw Current Events Episode 1, you know that bullying was the topic of that video too. And you would know that we ended it by having bullied people throw grenades into a pit filled with the people that bully them. This time, we have this.
So, you all invited here to play some paintball, crew?
Shut up, maggots!
What the damn hell?
All of you turd farmers are down there because you like to pick on others you think are less than you.
Well, but I don't think I...
Shut up, you butt-ugly ass pirate.
Okay.
Now you discharging gopher warts are going to be the fish in a barrel as four nerds here play some paintball.
You mean paintball, right?
Yes, you rancid pipsqueaks. It's paintball. Without the damn tea. Now scatter, you pus-sucking fatzos. Nerds, start shooting.
Be outside the crowd.